Hello there, I hope you are having a great day. Today I would like to talk to you about nail melanoma versus linear melanonychia. Melanonychia term comes from Greek, melano meaning black and nychia meaning nail. And it is a brown to black discoloration of the finger or toenail. Longitudinal melanonychia describes normally a pigmented band and is due to the melanin within the nail plate. Normally, well, it is benign and can be normally a mole, fungal infection, or even trauma. This is what happened to me, probably. So, melanonychia looks similar to nail melanoma or cancer of the nail. And while there is no evidence between cosmetic nail treatments and nail melanoma, you still have to check it with the dermatologist because, like most cancers, early detection and treatment increases your chances for a cure. And this is what I have done myself after 18 months when noticing the black line on my toenail did not go away. What I noticed all this time was the black line you see in the middle of the toenail and a very thin one on the left-hand side of the same toenail. So what I have decided to do is to go to my doctor. Of course, they had to refer me to somebody else, so in the end it took some 5 months from the moment I first went to a doctor to actually having the surgery. What the surgery involves is actually a biopsy, which means they have to take a small sample from the toenail bed. So this means that you have to have anesthesia, which normally hurts a lot, but it goes away very fast. So I had this local anesthetic and my doctor proceeded to remove the toenail. In itself, it took like probably 15 to 20 minutes. It took a longer time to actually prepare for this, and I did not feel anything. To that extent that I discharged myself from the hospital, and I decided to be very brave as to walk home. I'm not sure whether because of the surgery or me walking home, that when I arrived home, I noticed that even the bandages were very red. They were soaked in blood. And I was in a little bit of a pain. Not much. I was still able to walk in the house. But I noticed, so the surgery was on a Monday. On Friday, when I went back to the hospital to replace the bandages, I noticed that from that moment onwards, after replacing the bandages, I was not in pain at all. So it was a very, very light surgery. But even so, afterwards, it was simply a breeze. What I further did, I replaced the bandages once per week. And what I learned from the hospital, that basically I need to first disinfect the nail when removing bandage, for which I have created a saline solution as they do at the hospital. So basically you put less than a spoon of salt into 1 liter of water. And what I did, I disinfected using in this cotton buds. Then I applied the Mepitel, which is a white bandage. And then I applied the elastoplast in order to protect the bandages. This elastoplast was very poor quality, so as you can see there, I already prepared some glue, the Beacon 3-in-1, in order to make sure that the bandages will not come off. The next step was me, after 3 weeks, to start using breathable bandages, which I got from the hospital. As you saw there, you are shedding lots of skin around the toenail. It is normal because when you don't have the breathable bandages, of course that skin is going to dry out, so you are going to shed it. Right after the surgery, the skin at the back is going to be very white, as if you have been in water for ages. So this is all normal. So later on, after 4 weeks, there's no need even to use the bandages unless when you go out, you put your feet in shoes. So hoping that all this information was of any help to you, make sure you are going to check yourself and see what you have got. Do not let anything simply to think that is going to go away, because it is not. So I hope you are having a great day. All this information was of any help to you, and speak to you soon. Thank you for watching. Bye.